Long track speed skating is a sport which obviously is performed on ice. It's a big surface. It's a 400 meter rink. So one time around would be 400 meters. A skater has to cross on the back stretch, the way we call it, cross lanes. So in a lap you do an inner corner and on the other side you do an outer corner to make sure that every skater is doing a 400 meter lap. Within that, you always compete with two people at the same time. It's very simple. You have a start and you have a finish line, either after 500 meters, after 1,000 meters, 1,500 meters. The girls are skating 3,000, the men 5,000, and then the longest races are 5,000 for the girls and a 10,000 for the men. So we have a start and a finish line, and it's very plain and simple. The guy that is the fastest wins the race. It's been said that skating is the one sport in the world that without mechanic help, and now you can argue a little bit with the clap skate coming in, but it is actually without mechanic help. So with pure body that we hit the highest speeds of any sport. You know, I'm not considering downhill skiing, that works different, but on a flat surface, we generate the highest speeds, yeah, and they go up to almost 60K an hour, and that's on those small blades. For elite athletes, like the skaters who compete for Olympic medals, are basically all the skaters that are at the Olympic Games, there's customized equipment. The boots are molded to their feet. They're built up in a way that the skaters want them, with stronger areas, with softer areas, with the laces like this, with the laces like that. Then in skating, there's the, let's say, the modern version of skating, if we can still call it that way because it's been a long time since it's been introduced. But we have the new setting of clap skates, which is a hinge in the front of the foot, which allows the blade and the heel of the shoe to separate, and then it kind of snaps back, and that makes a clapping noise, and that's why it's called a clap skate or a snap skate. And then you have the blade, which is bigger than the foot, they're thin, and then there's mystery behind it, and that's for the spectators, that they will never see that, but skaters work with bends, so the blade is not straight. Skaters work with walkers, is what they call. Blades are not flat. You have to sharpen your blades to perfection, which doesn't mean like sharpen it like a knife, with a lot of people think, because then you would just cut into the ice, but it's like two perfect angles. So you have a flat area where you can glide on, and then when you tilt it, it grips the ice, and then you can actually push. So there's a lot of hidden things to a blade, and obviously a skater works to fine tune a blade to his technique, to his body, to his strengths, to his weaknesses, to corners, to straightaways, and somewhere within that you find the perfect setup. And it takes a while to find that. So there's a lot of things that a skater has to figure out as to what his ideal equipment is to be able to perform as efficient as he can.